Much, man. You know, I got a fight September 15th that I'm preparing for. Just got out here to Vegas to finish off camp and just getting ready.
You know anything about your opponent?
I know a couple guys he's fought. You know, he's fought Pedraza, Haney, Barbosa. Fought some good guys.
You ain't supposed to spill the news yet, son?
Huh?
Are you not supposed to spill the news yet?
No, it's out. I already know I'm fighting September 15th, Corpus Christi, Texas.
Introducing Astapro Outreach.
What's the guy's name?
I believe it's Antonio Moran.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, is that going to be at 135? Is that going to be at where we campaign?
It's going to be a catchweight at 38.
38?
Yeah.
So, tell me, is the weight starting to become an issue?
Not right now, no. For the last fight, there was just a lot of other issues going on within the camp and some injury I had to deal with, but we're all good now.
Okay. So what's the catch weight?
138.
Yeah. Nice. Are you excited to get back in there?
Yeah, man. It's been a long time. I'm really excited.
You know, your name's been mentioned a lot, especially with a lot of different interviews with Shakur. You know, it's nice to see someone my way that's getting the exposure and the publicity that you are deserved. Is that like a fight right now that you believe is realistic, you know, in your next, because you got a two-fight deal?
Three fights, yeah.
So talk to me, do you believe that's a realistic fight?
That's definitely a realistic fight. That's bound to happen.
You feel like just with, you know, let the time take its course, or do you feel like you got to be more outspoken?
Time will take its course. I know he needs a contender in there. I hear he's been looking for a fight, and after I handle business September 15th, we can get into discussion.
So, let's talk a little bit more about what's going on in the world of boxing today. You know, when it comes down to, you know, Devin Haney, you know, him trying to hold his WBC belt, you know, what do you think, why do you believe he wants to hold that belt, but in the same time fight Regis Prograis at 140?
Oh, just maybe see how he feels at 140. I don't think there's nothing wrong with capturing two titles in two different weight classes and holding two different belts at two different, I don't find a problem with that. You know, I'll do that myself. That's, to me, that's what pound for pound is all about. You know, being able to be champion in one, move up, move back down, whatever it may be, just no matter what, you're the best. So That's how I'm looking at it.
And that would be something that, you know, if names were on the table at 140 pounds, you would entertain, like you say.
Entertain, yeah, most definitely. Anybody at 140, if it's Teofimo, Devin Haney, any of the champions now, we could get it rocking.
Now that it, like, 40 starting to get hot, you know, it's starting to get hot.
Yeah. All the guys from 35 moved up, most of them, you know, and so the same fire division that was at 35 just moved over to 140. So same people.
Facts. So talk to me, man. I haven't seen no interviews of your reaction on, you know, the fight that just happened July 29th with, you know, Terrence Crawford and Errol Spence. What's your initial reactions to that?
I expected Crawford to fight the way he did. I just didn't expect for Spence to look that bad, if that can be worded correctly, you know?
Yeah.
So not to say that I knew that was going to happen. I didn't. I believed Crawford was going to win. I believed he was going to fight that way. I just didn't think it was going to look like how it did.
Round one comes. He shoots a 2-1. What's your initial thought? You know, did you feel like Errol Spence was in there with an elite guy, an elite southpaw at that, that he hasn't had too many southpaws, and kind of looked different because of that? Or you think he came in there looking a little different?
Who, Spence or Crawford?
Spence.
No. Spence looks the way he does. It's just Crawford just was at his tempo. Crawford was just doing what he does. So I did take note that he started softball because normally he does start off orthodox. And I thought that was a smart move, and it worked out for him.
Yeah, it seemed to me in some recent interviews, Bob Arum said that, you know, Spence really can't fight a southpaw, and a great southpaw at that. So it was smart for him to stay, you know, southpaw and not change to orthodox. But in your opinion, when it comes down to the rematch at 154, what would your prediction be?
Same thing. Same thing. To me, you know, speed is power. Crawford is the faster guy, more agile guy. Same thing.